Hello YouTube, I'd like to thank everyone who teamed up to help me reach the 1,000 subscriber threshold. And to thank you more tangibly, at least those of you who own an Ars Amigo lab box, I've got a project to turn my lab box into a Robo-Box. What's a Robo-Box? Well, it's a lab box that's been fitted with a motor that turns the knob so you don't have to do it. I try to make this a simple project for most people to build by following these criteria. First of all, it should be safe. It only uses 5 volt power, so you're not going to electrocute yourself on the water that's always around any kind of developing. It's pretty cheap. You can buy basically all the parts you need for under $50. It's easy. It doesn't require any special skills or any really elaborate tools. And you don't need to drill or cut the lab box, which I figured was important because it is kind of brittle and you wouldn't want to crack it or start any leaks. Now, here's how the Robo-Box works. If you're used to building hobby projects, you can probably look at this sketch and see everything you need to know. Basically, we're going to put 2 bends in a piece of metal to make a frame. The frame holds a motor unit on top of the lab box, and then an O-ring belt comes down and drives the knob so that you don't have to turn it by hand. Now, to build it, you'll need some parts that you can get from any hobby robotics supplier, such as Polaloo, Robot Shop, or Servo City, the one I used. You need a 12 volt gear motor. I used a 43 RPM motor, although I slowed it down by running it on 5 volts instead of 12. You need a hub to attach to the shaft of the motor. You need a 1 inch pulley to attach to the hub. And you need the O-ring itself. You'll also need a few ordinary odds and ends. You need the right size of bolts to attach the hub to the pulley, and you'll need a little hex key to tighten the set screw that holds the hub onto the motor shaft. If you don't already have a lot of stuff like this, you can probably find it in a hardware store, but it's really a lot easier to just order these 2 things at the same time you're getting the other robotics parts. You'll also need some odds and ends that you are more likely to have around the house. To make the frame, you'll need a strip of metal. I used a 12-inch long, 3/4-inch wide strip of brass, and you need about 6 large plastic zip ties. If you don't have those kinds of things around the house, you can probably find them at a hardware store, a hobby store, a craft store, or whatever. Step-by-step instructions are always kind of boring on YouTube, so I'm going to zip through this with a montage. To get the actual step-by-step instructions, you can download an illustrated PDF file from my website using a link that I'll put in the description. For now, just watch and follow along. Well, enough how-to. You want to see the thing work, don't you? Well, here you go. It's easy to use. You just put the frame over the top of your lab box and attach the belt. The belt tension is all you need to hold it in place. Turn it on and it starts rotating the knob for as long as you want it to go. You can pour your chemicals in and out without any interruption and take care of all of the other things you need to do to process a roll of film. Now, I hear you old timers though. You're saying, what about flow marks? If you don't know, when you're using constant speed agitation, you can get uneven development because the constant movement of the reel through the developer sets up flow patterns on the film. To get rid of those, you just give the tank an occasional sideways slosh, like that. Every 30 or 45 seconds is plenty. I also like to pre-wet my film with a 1-minute soak in plain water before I start developing. That way the developer acts more evenly on the film. Other than that, pretty much all you have to do is let the motor run while you're mixing your chemicals and pouring them in and out of the lab box until your process is finished. And if you use a water bath for color processing, you might want to know if the Robo-Box works in that, and the answer is, yes it does. So that's the Robo-Box. If you have an Ars Amigo lab box, I suggest you get building so you can stop knob turning.